In this presentation, we're going to allocate expense amounts to their proper classes. In other words, we currently have them classified as unclassified. We're going to assign them to a class, which will assign them to their function or their use, what they're going to be used for, which will include the admin, the fundraising, and the programs of community service and education. Let's get into it with Intuit's QuickBooks Online. Here we are in our not-for-profit company or organization dashboard. We're going to go on over to Excel to see what our objective will be. So we're going to be opening up the Excel. We are in the tab 10. So we're currently in tab 10. I'm going to scroll up and noting we're going to be considering our financial statements now. So you'll note we entered our information in the format of a trial balance here where we had to note some things in kind of vertical fashion, including the contributions with restrictions and without restrictions and so on and so forth. Now we're going to be going over to our statements and creating our statements with this. So we have the statement of activities. We'll note the statement of activities is now breaking this information out in more of a, I'm adding like a dimension to it where we have the with restrictions and without restrictions, or without donor restrictions and with donor restrictions. And that allows us to have basically one account that we can kind of break out in more of a column type of format. So we have that information. If we look at the expense side of things, here we have the expense side of things. Now on the expense side of things, we need to show in some way, shape, or form on the financial statements, both the expenses broken out by what they're used for, their function, we could call it, and what they are in terms of their nature. That would be like the normal use of them, utilities, phone expense, and so on and so forth. So here you'll note that we see it by their function, what they're used for, and then we would also give another report to break out their nature. So this is a report that shows them by nature, and that means rent, salaries, telephone, and then by function, the programs that they're used for, as well as admin and fundraising. But note, again, if we do that all in one report, this gets kind of overwhelming. So what we want to do is provide a report, you know, a little bit more information and then more information that is needed. So what we're going to do in QuickBooks is use the class feature to help us with that. So we obviously entered it into QuickBooks with the normal accounts, which are going to be the nature accounts. So they will show up by account on the reports. Then we're going to use the class feature to break it out by function so that we can add the functions that we want in the reports, and we can then collapse those reports or run different reports and use the collapsing feature and possibly use the collapsing feature in Excel to help us to present the reports in the way that we would want to make to meet our objectives, to make it easy to read, to provide the information that is necessary, and then to expand on them as needed. So what we want to do now, in order to do that, what we've done is we've entered our expenses in, and we just did the data input and let the data input be kind of separate from the allocating to the expenses in accordance with our percent breakout, because that's an easier thing to do. And then now that we have entered all the expenses into the system, we will see them in our profit and loss by class, all grouped into unclassified. Now we're going to be breaking them out in accordance to the percentages that we have determined that they should be broken out in. So we're going to go back into all the unclassified areas, and we're just simply going to break out to the organizations by class, to the expense categories by class, between the public health, the education, the programs, these are the two programs, and then the management, or we put it in there as admin, and the fundraising. We're going to use the percentage breakout of the 20, of the 40, 20, 20, 20. Okay, let's take a look at it. We're going to go back on over to QuickBooks. We're going to open up the P&L first. So let's go on down to the reports to open up the profit and loss report. So we'll go to the reports here. We could open the profit and loss by class or just make one. So I'm going to go to the standard P&L here. And then I'm just going to make a profit and loss by class. I'm going to scroll back up top. We're from January to, we'll probably do this at the end of the month. So 013120. And then let's run that report. Running that report, there we have it. Now let's add the classes, selecting the drop down and add the classes. So we have the classes for it. We're gonna run that report. Gonna close the hamburger for now. Gonna hold down control and see if we're up at that 125. And here we have our information. Now what we're looking for are the items to the right, which are the items that are not specified. So we're gonna take each of these non-specified items and specify them to a category. So it might be a little bit easier if we were to filter this out. We could filter this out by just seeing the not specified column. So I'm going to go back up top and I'm going to say, all right, let's take a look at this and let's see if we can customize this report. And I'm going to go down to the filtering options. I'm going to go to the filtering options here. I'm going to use the classes. So once you check off the classes, it'll bring that up top. I'm going to select the dropdown and I want to look at the not specified. So I want to just see the not specified column and then run that report. And these are the items then that we need to go back into and adjust. Once we do, they'll be disappeared from this report. What I'm going to do then is I'm going to go up top. I'm going to duplicate this tab. I'm going to right click and I'm going to duplicate this tab. So now it's to the right. I'm going to go back to the tab to the left. I'm going to open up the hamburger and I'm going to open up another P&L, another profit and loss. So I'm going to open up another P&L. So we'll open this up and we want the P&L, the profit and loss. And I'll run the same dates up top. So I'm going to run the same dates. It's going to be January, let's say, to 01/31/20. And then I'm going to close the old hamburger up top. I'm going to run that report. And then let's take a look at this one by class as well. So I'm going to select the classes. So in the over here in the classes, just like we have in the past, going to run that report. And so now we have the comparison. So I've got these items, once they're classified, we'll see the classes show up here, and then we'll see the unclassified column disappear in the report to the right. This one, we may even want to filter down a little bit and customize this report, because what we're focusing in on this report is if we hit the filter option, we want to go to the classes. And for this one, what we really want are the unrestricted. So unrestricted, including the 20%, the 20%, the programs, and these items. Now, all you really need, I think, is to check the unrestricted, but I'll just check them all off and then run that report. And then as we move them from unrestricted, this report will then populate with the restricted items. All right, let's check it out. So I'm going to go back. I'm going to right click on this tab up top, right click on this and duplicate it. So we have room to on the left to do stuff. Then I'm going to go back to the P&L, the profit and loss. And now what I want to do here is every time I'm going to drill down into the actual data and then change it and change the allocation. And then I want to go back to this report. So every time I'm going to drill down on it, I'm actually going to create a new tab and then drill back down on it. I think this is the most efficient way to do it. So I want to be able to make a new tab. I'm going to right click on this tab up top, duplicate this tab. Then I still have it to the left, and now I'm going to open it on the right where I'm actually going to drill down and make my change here. So now I'm going to drill down and make the change. I'm going to drill down on this depreciation. So I'm going to zoom into it, go into the depreciation account. I'm going to close the hamburger up here again. It keeps on trying to open. And then I'm going to open that journal entry. This is an actual journal entry type of format is what was used. And so this is the one which was the adjusting entry. Now this depreciation, what we need to do is break that out now. We want to break that out by class. We want to assign the classes to it. So you might want to hold control and scroll down to get it to that 100% so it doesn't do anything funny. Are we at 100? And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to keep the original journal entry and I'm going to replace the debit now by assigning out the classes. So I'm going to say this is depreciation. Now I'm not going to put the amount here. I'll go back and add the amounts. What I'm going to do is add the classes that I want to go to. So I'm going to go to the classes and add those. I'm going to select the drop down to the right and we're going to just select the classes that are in unrestricted. So if the admin, which is 20%, the admin 20, and then I'm going to do it again. I'm going to say depreciation, tab, tab, tab. I'm going to add the other class, the next class, which is going to be fundraising at 20. I'm going to say tab, tab, and then I'm going to do it again. I'm going to say depreciation expense, and there we have it. And then we're going to pick up the next one in the class, which is going to be for the program at 20%. So the community program, tab, 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 and then one more. Too many tabs. We're going to go back here and say depreciation again. And we'll pick that one up and we'll pick up the last item here, which is going to be the education. And then I'm going to say tab, 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 tab. And then I'll adjust the amounts. I'm going to try to make this column a little bit larger. So if we make this column a little bit larger here, and I'm doing this just like Excel, I'm putting my cursor right in the middle of the column and then dragging out. And if we do it far enough, then we'll be able to see our percentages that we put in the name. So then we could just pull out the trusty calculator here. So I'm gonna pull out the trusty calculator. I'm gonna make it a little bit smaller. It's a fairly large calculator. And then I'm just gonna be picking up, now the amount is this 4,400, which we're gonna reallocate. So I'm gonna say, all right, 4,400, 4,400 times 0.2, 20% means that this one should be 880. So I'm gonna say 880 here, tab. And then I'm gonna pick up the next one, which is gonna be the 4,400, 4,400. Times this time 0.2, obviously, which is the 880. So 880 here, this one's 20% too, which is 880 here, and this one's going to be 40%, which again we could, I'll just put it in there. We're going to say 4400 times 0.4 and enter. Whoops, do that one more time. 4400 times 0.4 and enter, and that's going to be the 1760. All right, now if we compare that to what we have over here, let's just check it out on the depreciation. So that looks proper. So here it is here. Okay, so then let's go back on over. Now I'm gonna delete then the depreciation one. I'm gonna delete the top one. And now we should be back in balance. That's of course gonna be our check to see that if we're back in balance here. So then I'm gonna say save and let's do save and close. And yes, so there we have that. And there we have that. Now, this is gonna take us back to that detailed report. Now we should be able to go back up and then go back to our transaction detailed report, and here it is. So if we couldn't, we can go back to the prior tab if we need to, if we get lost in that transaction. So notice it disappeared here and the one that's not specified. It should then reappear in the profit and loss if we update this one, running the report. I'm in the profit and loss now, looking at the classifications unrestricted. And here it is, admin has now popped up. We have the 880 in the fundraising and the community service 880 in the education. Okay, let's go back over to the tab to the right and let's do this again. It'll be a little bit faster once we get used to this. I'll take a little bit of time here, but we're gonna go into the office supplies. Office supplies, we have the bill and then we have the check. I'm gonna be opening this one up. We're gonna open each of these up. Let's open the bill, little different type of form here. Let's make sure that we're at 100%. Yeah, it looks like we're at 100% here, so that's good. So this item I need to break out in a similar fashion. Same kind of idea here. We're going to be assigning these out. There's going to be going to office. We're going to say office supplies. And then I'm going to pick up the class first. So let's first pick up the classes. I'm going to select the drop down and say we want the 20% to admin. And then office supplies again. And we're gonna pick up the class then, this time going to drop down 20% fundraising. And then we want the office expense again, office expense. And then this time we want the amount going to the community service. And then we're gonna do it again. We're gonna say office supplies. And this time we want to hit the drop down and make that education. So then again, you can adjust the classes line here so that you can see the amounts. And once again, it's a little finicky sometimes, but if I close that up, then we can see the percentages. 20, 20, 20, 40 is what we want. So then I'm gonna be picking this up and I'm gonna say, all right, there's the 4,500 times 0.2, which is 900. So we would think that would be 900, and then of course the 4500 times 0.4 being 1800. So we have the 1800, then it's going to be applied to this 40%. Then you want to delete the item on the top, the original item that was on there for 4500, and then we should tie out again. So this amount up top should be the same, And then we're breaking out 900, 900, 900, and 1,800 so that we can apply to these classes properly. So then we're going to save that. So you're going to want to save and close, and that'll take you back to your prior report. Do the same thing for the second item in there, the 500. So I'm going to go into the 500 and do the same thing, this time with I believe it's a check form. Close this item out and then open up the 500. So we'll open this up, and again, I don't want, there, I got rid of it. So then we're gonna say this is gonna be, once again, office supplies. So I'll pick that up, office supplies. I'm gonna pick up the class, we'll say class. I'm gonna make it 20%. Next one, office supplies. And then we're gonna say this one is gonna be the next one, which is gonna be 20. Then I'll do it again. We're gonna say office supplies. And then we'll pick up the next one, which is gonna be the program of the community service. And then we'll do it again. We're gonna say office supplies. And then we'll pick up this one, which is gonna be the 40%. Then we can make this column a little bit larger so we can see our percentages, although we probably have them memorized at this point, 20, 20, 20, 40. So the 500, 500 times 0.2 is gonna be 100. So we'll put the amounts 100. There's one, forgot the one, just two zeros. It's not gonna do it. This one's 102, because it's 20% as well. This one's 102, and then 40%, well, just 200, we won't do the calculation on that one. Once again, you'll delete the original amount up top with the trash can, and that'll leave you with 100, 100, 100, 200, and they're broken out to our classes here, and then that'll add up to the 500 total, the same amount that we originally had in there. So then we're gonna scroll down, that looks good. We're gonna go ahead and say save and close, save and close. Then if we go back to our profit and loss, which is not specified, it should have disappeared over here, so it's no longer there. If we go to the P&L on this side, the P&L that's broken out by the classified errors, we're gonna say run that report, so it updates our report here. There we have the office supplies 100, or 1,000, 1,000, 1,000, and 2,000 for the education. If we look at Excel, that should tie out to what we have in Excel. So let's take a look at the breakout that we did here for the office supplies, which is also the 2,000, 1,000, 1,000, 1,000 as well. So let's go back on over, and we're actually gonna stop here. And we'll enter the rest of them next time. We'll continue with this process and enter the rest of the expense items as we go. So we're gonna continue. If we go back to that profit and loss on the right, we're going to continue to the rest of these and allocate these out, continue with our process. That's going to be it for now. Let's get out of here.